Hello, Mr. Nygren here. So, I am playing Total War 1942, a mod for Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. So, I'm playing as Germany, the Third Reich, also known as Deutsches Reich in German, which means German Reich. Alright, so we are playing the campaign, the World War II main campaign, and we are about to fight a battle of Berlin, Soviet Union, or the USSR in this mod, also known as the United Soviet Socialist Republics. They have attacked Berlin, the capital of the Reich, and they at first attacked this army outside of Berlin, consisting of mostly planes, including a jet fighter. They attacked that army four times, and we won all four times. After those four battles, we had very little left, so we moved new planes, U-88 planes and Messerschmitt 109 planes from Frankfurt, and almost emptied Frankfurt, and reinforced this army. Then we won another battle against the Soviet Union. We had also moved our army from Stettin to this spot, so we have an army here under Günther Alterbung, a general, and he has half the army consisting of Tiger I panzers or tanks, and he has the other half consisting of Messerschmitt 109 fighters, plus we have the general himself with a armored officer's car, bodyguard. And no, this general is different. Most generals have the armored officer's car, bodyguard. But this general, Günther Alterbung, he has a BMW motorcycle bodyguard. So that's the bodyguard in this army. And this army used to have the general George Battle, I believe. But that general died, so this army is without a general and only has a captain. Alright, and then in Berlin we have the Führer himself with this force, including a newly built jet fighter that has been in one other battle. It reinforced the battle that we fought outside of the city. So I played this battle before, and in that battle I had placed Günther Alterbung under AI control, and Captain Günther under AI control as well, and we played the battle in real time. We were about to lose it. We had lost both the jet fighters, etc., but for some reason, at the end of the battle, it crashed. The game locked itself. It game locked, and then it crashed a few seconds after. And that's how the prior episode ended. So now we are going to fight it again. And the army under Günther Alterbung had problems moving the tanks into the city because there were some city buildings in the way. So we will not let Günther Alterbung be controlled by the AI anymore. We will control him ourselves, and then Captain Günther with the planes. I believe this army could still be AI controlled. So we will only control the Führer and his small garrison, and then we will also take control over Günther Alterbung and his Tiger I's and planes as they arrive. And because that will enable us to micromanage the army, so we can make sure they can pass those buildings that are blockading their path into the city. And then Captain Günther with the planes, he had no problem moving before, so I guess he will do fine on his own. Alright, so we will fight the Battle of Berlin, the Reichshauptstadt, or Reich capital. Alright, fight the battle on the battle map. So this mod is for Rome Total War and Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion, but not for Alexander.
Formiert euch, Männer, und zerquetscht die Feinde des Kaisers!
So Hitler in this mod doesn't have a unique model, because this is not based on Alexander. So he has a generic officer's model, a general model. Start deployment. Alright, we'll do the same thing we did the last time. We'll place everyone at the center of the city. Start with all the units here. Loose formation and guard mode for now. We'll place the Führer here too. And loose formation. Oh, we didn't want that change. Okay, and I believe they should be grouped. And AI assistance, I believe. No, maybe they weren't AI controlled the last time. We will not use that. Okay, and so that's the army we control at start. Then there should be some reinforcements somewhere on this side. Maybe they show up when we start the battle. The enemy army, they have a lot of planes, Yak 9 planes and MiG 3s. Fighter planes, all of them. The Soviet Union do not have bombers in this mod, which is why we will never use the Stukas if we can avoid that, because their fighters are superior. The U-88s are supposed to be a mix of fighters and bombers, but they sucked, so they were not good either. The Messerschmitt 109 fighters are the only ones that can fight these, and the jets, of course. The U-88s, they have too short range, and they fire their bombs, and they also have too low defense, so they are easily taken down. Stukas, they are very good at defending positions with their tactical bombings, but they suck against other planes. Okay. So the Soviet Union, they have some T-34-85s here as well, their best tank in this mod. Of course, they have an even better one in the files and in custom battle, but I managed to screw up, you know. There were like four buildings in the EDB or export desker buildings file where you add all the recruitment and such, but in the game the fourth building had been disabled by Degovax because they only made custom buildings that are visible here. So you can see heavy tank factory, it's the third level. He only made three custom city buildings and deactivated the fourth one, and I added the best stuff to the fourth one thinking it was still in the game. So that's why we don't have the best Soviet tank or the best German tanks like the Tiger II and the Maus. But I will probably play this game again after changing a lot of stuff like the stats and maybe adding new units and such, and when I do that I'm gonna change things in the recruitment so that the best stuff will be in the third level, and then we will have the medium stuff in the second level and the light stuff in the first level. But I thought there were four levels, so that's why we didn't get the best stuff. Same issue is true for artillery, I believe. The best artillery is not in the campaign either. Okay, so we can start the game. As we can see, the armies are about to enter. Let's pause the game. We want the tank unit here to arrive as soon as possible to the city center. We want all the units to fight in the city center and defend. Reinforcement, Gunter Alterbung, under my control, and Captain Gunter under AI control. Look here, this is Captain Gunter with all the planes, including the jet fighters, Messerschmitt 102, the Messerschmitt 262 fighter jets, or ME 262 fighter jets. Okay, then we have the army that is on under my control, but they haven't entered yet. They need to enter before I can select them. We'll do that. General himself do not need to enter immediately. Let's return to this area. We want the tanks to go there as soon as possible. Also place them in loose formation. So they are less likely to be hit by enemy fire. Same with the tanks, of course, they will take a longer time to get to the center. Loose formation and get to the center as fast as possible. Run forward or speed, speeding forward. Okay, as soon as possible to the city center. Even the general can get to the center as soon as possible. Lose formation on that tiger tank as well. Then the final one, lose formation. Move it to the group and hurry up to the city center. All the units go to the city center. Alright, so the planes have already arrived, very good. Our Tiger ones are arriving now. Awesome. Get any trouble to enter because of this building here. They all got stuck here previously. To get that problem now, I will have to move them manually past this building. Alright, move over here. This could be annoying. Let's place them in close formation. Move them there. Move them over here instead, actually. The other army under Captain Gunther has reached this area. The fight here in the air has started. Lots of planes here fighting the airplanes, just like in the previous battle. Here we have some planes that have entered. Planes didn't have a problem entering the city. We also have Soviet planes fighting here. There's a dog fight in this area. Problem is the tanks, as usual. This building might need to be moved for the tanks to be able to enter, and other infantry, otherwise some of them will always get stuck. Either move this building, or remove it, or enable a different pass from this side, because they enter here and then they get stuck. Some of them will manage to pass into the city, but most of them get stuck. So that's a problem. Try to move them. Tanks. Let's move it there. They have a hard time listening to commands here because of the path. Some of them did now. Good that they have tight formation, but they are easier to move if I have it if I have them on tight formation. Otherwise, they tend to be too far away from each other, so only a few of them will least area where I want them to be. Let's remove this text here. Let's pause the game and remove the text. Okay, so we need to move the tanks. Okay, so the battle is going on here. We are still holding center, but the Soviet planes have also entered here. Shit! Faction leader dies! Adolf Hitler is dead! Our leader is dead! Alright. Hitler didn't manage to hide in this battle. In the last battle he was still alive when the game crashed, and by then the battle was almost over. All the planes had been pretty much shot down, all the jets at least, and most of the tanks had also been killed, and they led the balance of power meter. They are still leading here, but it was lower, it was probably here somewhere. Alright, so we have lost 7%. In that battle we had lost 22% and 27%. They had lost 37, and we had lost 22, I believe. Now they have lost 22, and we have lost 7. And Hitler didn't survive the battle. But we still have our air in Hamburg or Amsterdam. I believe it's Hamburg. The air is Erwin Rommel. Okay. So he is still alive, but he doesn't have an army. Rouen in France only has 2 units, so it's lost. Amsterdam has only 4 units, I believe, with a general. It will also be easily taken by the Spanish state or the Soviet Union. And then we have Hamburg, where we only have Erwin Rommel himself. And then also we have Copenhagen, the capital of Denmark, where we have like 1 or 2 infantry units. They will also easily take that one, and Stettin with a few infantry units and 1 plane. It will be taken by the Soviets after this battle, I'm pretty sure about that. They will attack. And then we have Oslo, the capital of Norway, held by 1 infantry unit. It would be easily taken, but the AI never goes there for some reason. It's separated by the sea from land, so they can't go there by land. They need to send a fleet there. The AI never does, so I think they are safe. That's why we could move Erwin Rommel there. He would be pretty safe there. But it would be pretty boring, because that city can only, or village or town or whatever, it's the capital of Norway, but it's like a town in this game anyway. It can only recruit assault infantry, and they are worthless anyway. So I guess now that Hitler is dead, that the most logical thing to do is to just defend until someone wants peace with us. We will also send our diplomat to speak with the enemy to try and make peace, but of course we can't use total diplomacy with the enemy, because that would be wrong. So they will need to agree to the peace terms or offer their own peace terms. We won't use the total diplomacy function to do that. And if they do not offer peace, we might be destroyed instead. We will see. Either we will accept to become a protectorate, or we will be destroyed. But the Führer fell in this battle, and Erwin Rommel, I believe, is more willing to make peace than the Führer. So we don't have much of an army anyway. The Spanish state could easily take Rouen and Amsterdam and Copenhagen, and the Soviet Union will take Stettin. Then we only have Frankfurt, Copenhagen and Oslo. I believe Copenhagen will also be taken by someone, so it's Oslo and Frankfurt. Frankfurt is a good large city, and there we can get the jet fighters, but we have far too few planes there to be able to hold for long. They will attack there in a few few turns, maybe even one turn, and then it will be over after that. Alright, they've taken out a lot of our tigers here. Ultra-Bunks general is here. General's bodyguard, VIP bodyguard. Alright. Quite a few BMVs in the back. What about the stuck tank? There are a few that are still stuck here. I want them to move in to the city actually. Right there. So the planes are easily taking out the tanks on the ground. Really good tanks with a really good projectile, but doesn't help much against the planes. We have some planes here too, the U88 guy and planes here, they are ours, but probably lose. Oh, we might be able to win this battle. 30% allies killed, 33% enemies killed, but if we win the battle, we have still lost the leader. Alright, Captain Igor of the USSR or the Soviet Union also fallen. But let's pause the game. About the city center kind of ruined it, and then the leader died. That means we don't need to hold the center in the same way anymore. Let's just place them under AI control and guard mode, and that's it. And of course we need them to attack, of course. Firing. They have a really good projectile, but it's likely we could actually win this battle. In the other battle we were at a disadvantage, but in this battle we managed to get most of our troops into the city. In the other battle I believe most of the tanks, and I believe like 80% of the tanks were stuck here. Well, now we have like one that is still stuck, so that's why it's going much better this time. The only thing that went worse is that we lost the Führer. He was still alive because he managed to get here somewhere where he was protected by the building. But in this battle they managed to shoot his car down. So that's why we do not have any leader to protect anymore in the city. So they do not need to hold the center as much. Of course, if the timer is starting to tick down, then of course we need to send something to the center to prevent them from winning. Because if someone, if the enemy holds the center for 2 minutes, we will lose. So it's important to hold the center, but we do not need everyone to be there anymore. Originally I wanted everyone in the center to defend the Führer, because the campaign is of course more interesting if the leader is alive. But now we still have Erwin Rommel. Just means a change in policies. And we have Gunther Altenburg here, the other general of this battle still alive. A few Messerschmitt 109 fighters in the air. What is happening here? You see MiG-3s fighting the U-88 combat, multiple combat aircraft. Here we have more of their planes fighting our ME-262 jet fighter. We have also a Messerschmitt 109 fighter there. The jets are very powerful, very good defense, very good attack, and they are of course faster too than other planes. So they are hard to shoot down, they are not invincible, as we saw in the prior episode, in the previous episode. They can be shot down, but they are much harder to shoot down than the other planes. A unit of jet fighters can take down quite a few of the ordinary planes before going down. There are 3 planes in each unit, I believe, when they are at full strength. So if it's just one yet there now, then they have still taken down a few. Battle was a little more epic to look at in the prior battle, but in this battle it went better for us. In some ways, it looks like we are winning the battle. In the previous one, we would have lost, but the Führer was still alive at the end. But he would still have been killed probably before the battle would be over. But he would be one of the last units to be killed. Well, in this battle he was one of the first units. Okay, they took down a U-88 heavy bomber here. Or multiple combat aircraft plane. 40% allies killed, 39% enemies killed. We have killed 2% more of them than in the previous battle. Here we killed 37% of their troops. One good thing was that the jet fighter didn't get stuck here in this battle, unlike in the other where it got stuck between these buildings here and then shot down. Sometimes those buildings can prevent them from shooting at the enemy. Alright, so the planes here are AI controlled. I can't take over control over them myself. Well, these units are under my control, but I've placed them under temporary AI control. What about the tank over here? We still have one tank here. It's just one left now, let's move it to the front. Alright, fast forward to that spot. This is the Battle of Reichshauptstadt Berlin. Okay. Only artillery in this mod can destroy buildings. Planes and tanks aren't counted as artillery, that's why they can't bomb buildings. Which is kinda sad, but that's why we need artillery if we want to, you know, demolish the buildings of a city. And I will probably, before replaying this, we'll probably add a lot of artillery to starting armies so we can have some demolishing of cities. Because the artillery aren't that good when it comes to battles, because they are handled by crews, and the crews are easily destroyed by the planes or tanks. So they are very unreliable, but if you are besieging a city, then they are really good, because they can destroy entire cities, unlike in Medieval 2 where you can only damage buildings. In this game, Rome to the War, and mods based on Rome to the War, you can actually destroy the buildings 100%. So this entire city could be destroyed if we had artillery, or if Soviet had artillery. But of course, they have limited ammunition, so if you only have like one mortar, you can only take down a few buildings. If you have an entire army of artillery, for example, then you could destroy pretty a lot of the city, a huge portion of the city. If many artillery armies, then of course, or armies made up of artillery, then you can destroy entire cities in this mode. Had quite a few GU-88. Planes as well. Alright. So what's happening? They are fighting a MSM-109 fighter here, but it's outnumbered. It's fighting 4 other planes. We'll probably lose that battle. Then in this area we still have the jet and at least 3 Messerschmitt gonna land fighters fighting the airplanes. I think we will win in this area. Because we have the numerical advantage. I believe we are about the same number, but we have the jet fighters, so that's why I think we will win in this part. This area. And in this area they are superior in numbers. They will probably win this in the end. And they've already taken out a lot of the tanks and BMW motorcycles. We have a few here. The general himself can't fire, I believe, unless he has a pistol. Yeah, he has a pistol, he can fire too. We have a few tanks here as well. Plus, it's still held by us. We have another jet fighter in the center, too, actually. We have some other planes, so they are far from winning the battle. Alright, and then we have 39% enemies killed, 15% allies killed. Let's zoom in on the map. Get a better overview. We can fast forward. So, we can have some results here. Plane battles usually take forever, so we need to have fast forward one to speed them up. I just wanted to enjoy the scene, to enjoy the battle, but now I just want the air battle to be over. So we'll see what will happen here. We will speed up the dogfight. See what planes remain in the air at the end. This scene is of course of most importance. We had quite a few planes here. But in this battle, we had more planes in this area than in the previous battle. So I think we will manage to recruit them down. Hopefully we will win this. It took a while for them to win there. Hopefully the game will crash again like it did last time. It's very annoying when it's a CTD at the end of the battle before it's over. So you need to replay it again. That would be annoying. Right, so it takes forever before they are actually shooting down the planes. This is AI controlled planes. I can't really click on them either to do anything. They are firing at each other, so it should be over after a while. I believe the Soviets sent in more planes here. They had more planes inside of the city. Building lost, building captured, etc. That will change all the time. Alright, so we have more planes here, where the Soviets are in numerical superiority. We have some tanks on the ground. And now the battlefield became foggy. And more tanks here. Still holding the plaza, but the Soviets have sent in some planes here to fight the plaza as well. The most interesting battle currently. See if they can win here with the help of the ME-262 jet fighter, or if they will be shot down despite the jet. I'm surprised they haven't shot them down yet. They are missing or something. If this building is somehow protecting the Soviet planes there. That's surprising. Let's see the statistics. 17% allies, 45% enemies. We are taking down some of their planes. We went from 39% to 45%. We went from 15 to 17%. Ground action as well. were still alive, so we had quite a few tanks. We had half an army of Tiger 1 tanks in this battle under Gunter Ultraboom. No tanks are stuck anymore, all the tanks have reached this area, that's why the battle went so much better for the army, not for the Führer. Alright, so the battle will most likely be won now. 17% allies killed and 45% enemies killed. The previous battle, the plane air force arrived here and got defeated, and the tanks were stuck, so they couldn't really use all their tanks in the battle, and then the army here got 100% defeated, with the exception of the Führer, but had the game not crashed, he would probably have died before the end of the battle. And the city would have been taken, the center, and we would have lost, and most of the tanks would still be alive, but would be stuck here. So this battle, because we put the arm under Gunter Ultraboom under our control, went better, because we managed to get all the battles into the actual fight. And with the help of the Tiger 1s here, we could actually win the battle. Even if we fail to protect the Führer. But even if we win the Battle of Berlin, they will most likely attack again. Maybe not immediately. They might. They might attack immediately if we're unlucky. They took down one of our Messerschmitts. But our jet fighter is still in the air. I wonder if they will take it down too. If they'll be able to take those planes down. Alright, we can just wait on this to be resolved. 17% still, 45%. Let's find that whole building in Berlin. One of the churches, so we can get a better overview. Power here made us move up with the camera. Now we can see better what is happening. We're still holding the center. Let's return to the area of the battle. Dogfight here. Clean our jet and the airplanes. They have the numerical advantage, we have the technical advantage. Alright, we'll see what will happen here. Of course I'm gonna nerf the planes in the next... but oh, the timer is up! We have 40 minutes to hold the city before we win. Now it's only 2 minutes remaining. We will win in 2 minutes. That's the only way we could have won in the prior battle if Hitler was still alive and in the center and they didn't take it in time. Now we will win thanks to the timer. Which is very good for us. Alright, 1 minute and 38 seconds remaining. So at the center we have the planes, Messerschmitt 109 fighters, we have 2 jets at least. We have some tanks outside, Tiger 1s. And the fight is still going on here, we have some tanks fighting still. U-88s in the air. Then we have the fight going on here, the dogfight, where many of their MiG-3s and Yak-9s are fighting our Mi-262 fighter jets. And most likely now we will be able to win this battle thanks to the timer. 40 minutes have gone past and they failed to take the city in time. In Road to the War, if you fail to take it in 40 minutes, you will lose. The problem was that we lost the lead and then they won't replay it. Unresolved. 10 seconds kvar. 10 seconds left. I said that in Swedish. Got excited. Alright, 10 seconds remaining. Now it's less. Battle is over. We have won. Yeah, average victory. So your armies, Adolf Hitler had 471 men deployed, killed 94, 382 remaining. He fell in battle, the Führer is dead. Captain Gunther had 89 planes, killed 125 of the enemy, have 58 remaining, and the enemy army under Captain Igor had 488 men, killed 181, and have 267 remaining. And here's the detailed statistics. I won't forget to move this down this time. I forgot that in a few battles. You can see the second army there under Captain Gunther, and the first army under the Führer. Okay, now let's return to the battle map. The Battle of Berlin was resolved, and the German Reich was victorious. But the Soviet Union will probably launch more attacks against the capital. Maybe we won't win against another assault. Yeah, they attacked immediately. Now it's Sergei Ivanov with 353 men that is attacking. They are attacking Captain Gunther outside of the capital. So it's a battle outside of the city, but we are reinforced by Captain Richard from inside. That means the Führer really died. He didn't survive. So Captain Richard is inside the city, and he will reinforce the air force outside. So the battle will be like the battles before the Battle of Berlin. Sergei Ivanov have one unit of Stokes mortar artillery, two units of riflemen, and one unit of assault infantry, two units of Jack 9 planes. One has been in battle before, but has only achieved or received slight damage, lost maybe a few, maybe one plane or something. Then we have the MiG-3s, they have two of those as well. And we have the armored officer's car. I believe this is such a general. It's a rifleman general, so it's from a starting army. It's not a real general then. Okay. So we will save the game. And fight this battle as well. And the reinforcing army will not be controlled by the AI. Okay. Fight the battle on the battle map.
Formiert euch, Männer, und zerquetscht die Feinde des Kaisers. Die Feinde des Reiches werden nicht entkommen.
Start deployment. Place the army in loose formation, group it, and AI control. Start the battle, pause the game. And now we need to find the enemy army here. There it is. They had quite a few planes. Alright, start the game. Start the battle, I mean. Alright, so another battle outside of Berlin. We will order the other units to move into the army as soon as possible to reinforce it. Then we'll pause the game and click on them again to attack. Just need to wait on the U-88 to arrive. Let's select it, pause the game. And click on them to attack, because the new units need to be selected to attack as well. We have the reinforcing planes here. They are moving towards the front. quite a few planes. The enemy had also a lot of planes. They also had infantry. This battle, they're easily routed, as we've seen in prior episodes. And they had a general with riflemen. Since a bad general, it will probably be killed easily. Bad bodyguard for a general. We have two jet units at least, so we restored some planes from the victory in Berlin. Let's fast forward, otherwise it takes forever. Okay, balance of power is to our benefit. 2% allies killed, 9% enemies killed. Let's fast forward, otherwise this will take forever. I like the modern roads like this. Alright. Yeah, the Jets will be able to win this for us. I don't know, but the Soviet Union might make... might attack again after the battle. They usually attack 2, 3, or 4 times before a turn is over. They have a lot of armies after all. Okay. We'll see. Some of our Austin team that are already routing here. So Erwin Rommel is now the new leader of the Reich, the new Führer. And unlike Hitler, he is not as much of a warmonger. He is a great general, of course, but he is suicidal. He would want peace as soon as possible. But it needs to be achieved on good terms. Alright, so if they offer us protectorate status, we will accept that. Or if we can somehow convince them to a peace deal. But until then, we'll continue to fight the war. And the war is against both the Spanish state in the east and the Soviet Union in the east. And if they do not offer any peace or protectorate status, then we will fight to the death. We won't care about Oslo. It's they never attack it anyway. So it doesn't count really. We can only recruit infantry there anyway, so we wouldn't be able to, you know, use it as a base and get the jets from there or something. The jets are only available in German areas anyway. And any other units are too weak against the massive forces of the Soviet Union. They have a million armies. Only armies of jets could probably, or entire battalions of jets could possibly defeat that. But we do not have the luxury to get as much of those planes as we would wish. I mean, Frankfurt can still build those planes and Berlin, but these cities will probably be taken soon. Berlin in 1 or 2 turns, maybe even this turn, and Frankfurt in maybe 4 turns it will be taken, so we won't get enough of the jets out to change the war. From Oslo we could have obviously won the battle, but we could have gotten the jets from there, but we can't. So. Alright, so the balance of power is tipping to our side even more. 49% enemies killed, 47, 22% allies killed, 48% enemies killed, 49. Alright, so yeah, we will win. But it's kinda boring to watch battles like this, so I will change the planes to be as overpowered in the future. I wanted them to be better than the tanks, because that's historically accurate. You wouldn't be able to win against planes with tanks, but in a game it's probably more fun if you could take down the planes with tanks as well. The only unit that I think should remain weak is the infantry. The planes need to be weaker so that tanks have more of a chance. Alright, we won the battle. Let's check the balance for power here. 64% enemy skill, 22% ally skill. Let's continue the battle then. Because we want it to be at 84 if we can make it. So they are retreating. I don't see their troops anymore. Here is some infantry. They're retreating. Sent the planes here. Shooted them. We annihilated those infantry units there. Good job, jet fighters. Clear victory! Your army, Captain Gunter, had 175 men, killed 231, very good. Men remaining 83. Enemy army under Sergei Ivanov had 353 men, killed 43, 104 remaining. Here's the detailed statistics. And let's return to the map now and hope they won't attack immediately again. They might do that. We won the battle, and they didn't attack, but Portugal attacked somewhere. They've attacked Rouen, so it wasn't the Spanish state, but Portugal that attacked. They took Bordeaux from us previously, and now they are taking Rouen as well. We have two plane units and one infantry. We have a Stuka tactical bomber and a Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane, and we have a rifleman unit, and the enemy, Portugal, has a Italian Fire 3000 tank. They have a scout sniper unit and a rifleman unit. So they have the upper hand in infantry, and then they have the Hurricane plane and the Wellington plane. So I'd say they have the upper hand in this battle. Actually, we could just automatically resolve that battle. Portugal took Rouen, an area of France. France was divided between the Spanish state and Portugal. Each of them took one area each. But Spain, they took Lyon from each of France as well. So they have more of actual France. Faction leader killed Adolf Hitler. Our leader has been vilely slain. Someone must pay for this outrage. Someone must suffer the weight of German vengeance. Alright, so the Führer is dead. That means the war is over. It is still ongoing, but it means there is not much cause to continuing the war. Let's see here. We will move some planes to this force, maybe, or... Yeah, I think we will move this... let's see here, we have Berlin. Let's move the planes inside of Berlin. And, oops, I maybe shouldn't have done that. Let me move that inside of Berlin. Move all the planes inside of Berlin then. We have three slots left. Alright, so then we have some tanks here. We will move Gunter Alterbung and his army. Maybe we won't do that. So we have a family member in Amsterdam. We have a Rommel in Hamburg. Hamburg. So let's this infantry unit will be moved to Amsterdam. Hamburg, we have the air, Erwin Rommel. Let's move him zeigen.
Der Marsch endet heute hier, Kaiser.
Und
eure Befehle?
Move this army to Stettin under Gunther Alterbung. And move plain unit here as well. Move another plain unit to Stettin. Another one. This general to Hamburg, actually. Frankfurt, we have a few units. Amsterdam can be abandoned, it's not part of Germany anyway, it's the capital of Belgium. We move a plane from there to Frankfurt instead, to make Frankfurt more heavily defended. Move these two infantry units to Frankfurt as well. Frankfurt is more important, we can get the jets from there. We have 2 turns left until another jet arrives. Here we can start building construction of another jet fighter. We will do that. So another Me-262 jet fighter in Berlin. It will take 4 turns to construct, I believe. I think it's 4 turns, yes. Okay, diplomatic information. The following factions have declared a ceasefire: the Italian Empire and the French Republic, and the Italian Empire and the United States of America. Settlement besieged Rouen by Portugal. Settlement enslaved Rouen. So Portugal enslaved the population in Rouen. End of turn report. We are plus 3097 in profits. New faction leader, Erwin Rommel. Your family has a new leader, surely a man to uphold German dignity and family virtue in the face of threats from outside and within our borders. Alright. I think we will check the faction strengths of the game. So, the faction strengths. So this is Germany's overall rating. We have gone down this far. Alright, and then we have military strength. We are almost defeated there as well. Let's check the top 5 factions. So we have the United States at the 3rd place in the world. We have Imperial Japan or the Japanese Empire as the strongest faction in the game. They are actually the strongest faction. And then we have the British Commonwealth of Nations, or the British Empire, at place number 4 in the world. So the United States is number 3 and Britain is number 4. We have the United Nations, or League of Nations. They changed the name to League of Nations, that's more correct. So League of Nations are the 5th strongest faction in the world. They are holding the entirety of South America. And the Soviet Union, or the United Soviet Socialist Republics, the USSR, they are at place number 2. They used to be the strongest, but Japan has just passed them. So one Axis power is still counted as very strong, while the others have almost been defeated. Italy isn't even in this list. Okay. Let's check the overall rating for top 5. I think Japan is still the strongest, but it's very close between them and the Soviet Union. The Soviet Union might actually be stronger in overall. And it's very close between Britain and the United States too. While the League of Nations are way behind. And Germany is, of course, almost defeated. What about Italy? They are still in the game. The Italian Empire. They are there, down there. So they are about the same strength as us, slightly stronger than us. Hungary, Bulgaria, etc. They are defeated. Romania defeated. Finland defeated, Thailand defeated, Chinese Republic defeated, People's Republic of China defeated. Spanish state is about the same strength as us. They are actually stronger than both German and the Italian Empire. They've gained some strength recently, but not much. Portugal, they are not far below us. They are slightly below these three. The Spanish state, the German Reich, and the Italian Empire. The French state Vichy are defeated. Spain defeated them, the Spanish state. And India, they are pretty strong actually. They are there. They are still weaker than us. We have Turkey, they are defeated. We have the French Republic, the Free French, they are pretty strong. They are stronger than all of us down here, and are the closest to the League of Nations out of these factions. Alright, and that's all the nations in overall rating. And in military, I believe we have the same situation there. Alright, now I think we can try to speak with factions actually. It's time to make peace. We speak to the British Empire here. Ah, that was a spy, I didn't know. I forgot that a female is a spy, not a diplomat. We will use a diplomat and speak with them instead. We want map information. Demand items to create a proposal. So map information. To remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal. That's what we need right now. Alright, and about peace. We'll try to get peace with the British. Ceasefire, trade rights. Alright, we'll give a region to them if they accept. We'll get Oslo. And that's all. While your offer of territory is generous, we do not think we would keep it for long before your armies march in, and so we reject it. Alright. That's not good. Try again. Ceasefire, trade rights. Banding words is pointless. It's a pointless waste of breath at this time. So the British do not want peace at the moment. Yeah. I won't use total diplomacy against their enemies that speak to the Soviet Union. We want their map information first. We do use total diplomacy for that. Okay. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal. Then we will speak to them again. Ceasefire, thank you. Trade rights. Oh, they didn't agree with that. We give you some regions then. We can give you Oslo and Copenhagen and Hamburg. No, Oslo and Copenhagen and Amsterdam if you accept. Oh, they offer ceasefire trade rights. Give Oslo and Copenhagen, of course. So we have peace with the Soviet Union. No, I might have actually... no, something went wrong there. It doesn't seem like they actually accepted it. I thought they accepted it, but I still hold those areas. Let's speak to them again. Ceasefire trade rights and give region Oslo, Copenhagen and Amsterdam. Make single payment. And we'll try. No, they didn't want it, surprisingly. Okay. Speak to the Italian Empire.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items.
Show it below. Left click on an item in the proposal. Okay, map to information from the Italians.
A very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
Okay, we have the United States, the Soviet Union down there. Should have a diplomat here too. We want peace with Portugal. What about ceasefire and trade rights? They agreed. Peace with Portugal. Ceasefire in effect. The Third Reich in Portugal. The war is over with Portugal. They are holding Bordeaux here and Rouen areas in France. We also want peace with the Spanish state. So we will go to the Spanish state next. Their capital. Ceasefire. Thanks. End the fighting. This is a good joke. We see no need to end the fighting between our peoples just yet. Some of you yet live. That's not good. Ceasefire. Trade rights. Map information. Map information. Give region. Alright, but if you get Amsterdam and you get Copenhagen, oh, they didn't want peace. Spain refused my peace offer. Urban Romans' peace offer. Okay. And we could check the map actually. Toggle FOV. Toggle V. So the map is now visible. So we'll zoom in. We can see Japan now. So there's a rebel area over here, held by the neutrals. But Japan has done very well. They've even taken some of the ISILs down here. We will need to check that in more detail soon, because I didn't know they actually would do that, because they are separated by sea there. But they have also entered India. We will check them soon. So we can see the Soviet juggernaut has taken all of these areas, taken Finland, taken the Baltic, they've taken Kyiv, Ukraine, I mean, and they've taken Belorussia. They have taken most of Germany and Austria. They have taken Czechoslovakia. They've taken Romania. Taken Hungary. Taken most of Bulgaria. One city of Bulgaria is held by the British. Alright, and they've taken Athens from Greece or the Italian Empire. They have taken Zagreb here. I don't know if that's Albania or not. And yeah, they are at the border with Italy here. They even took Verona at one point, and now want it back, probably. They are trespassing in Italian territory. Okay. So the Soviet juggernaut has a huge area that they control. They even have areas in Turkey. But they haven't entered the Middle East. It's still held by the British and the French. Spanish state. They have their starting areas, including the area in Africa, El Layun. But they have gone and taken Lyon from Vichy France, and they've taken Marseille from Vichy France as well. And they've taken Paris from us, and they took Brussels from us as well. The Italian Empire is still holding Italy, but Palermo revolted from the Turkish. We gave that, I believe Turkey took this area, then it revolted, alright. And Italy took all these areas all the way to Istanbul, but now the British Empire have taken Saloniki and Istanbul, and the Soviet Union have taken Athens and Zagreb. Otherwise, they are still holding their peninsula, with the exception of Sicily here. Okay. Portugal took Bordeaux and Rouen. Britain is still in control of mainland Britain. And Germany still holds on to Berlin, Frankfurt, and Hamburg, and Stettin. So four German cities. Amsterdam is the capital of Belgium, held by Germany still, and we have the capital of Denmark and Norway too, Copenhagen and Oslo. Okay, and then if you go into Africa, you can see that the United States of America has taken Tripoli, Tunis, Algier, and Casablanca, even Marrakesh. And they've taken areas down here, they've taken Nouakchott, and Bernaco. Then we have the French Republic, they have a few areas here, but the real winner here is the British Commonwealth of Nations, also known as the British Empire. They've taken all the areas from Italy in Africa, taken Ethiopia here, and they've also, together with the French Republic, taken our areas over there. Alright, if you check South America, it's still untouched, held by the United Nations. They are holding all of South America. It's the Roman Senate faction, keeping the allies together. But we can see that the United States of America, they are still holding their starting areas, but Canada is still held by the British, and then Mexico here, held by the United Nations, and they haven't touched that area. However, the United States also had Panama from the start, and they have moved their troops inside of South America. They haven't taken any areas yet, but it looks like they are planning a war against the Roman Senate, or in this mod, the League of Nations. So there might be a war between the United States and the League of Nations in this mod soon. Okay, then we have the Soviet Union. They have their areas in the east. They've taken some areas too. Like, I believe they had those areas from the start, but they might have taken one or two areas, I'm sure. No, I think the Soviet Union are holding on to the areas they had at the start. This area, Urumehi, I think it was either Chinese or Soviet at the start. The Japanese Empire, they have destroyed the Chinese Republic that held most of China. They have also destroyed the communists in China. Then they went on and destroyed the Taiwanese here, or Thailandish. Thailand was destroyed, even though they started as an ally of them. And then they've gone down here. They had an army outside of Singapore at the start, but now they have somehow managed to send their troops to these ISILs here. Still have a British army here. Derek Montgomery, but they've taken this area, Palembang, from the United States. Then they moved here, taken this area too from the United States. They have taken all of these areas. I don't know, this might be the Philippines, Kuching and Balikpapan. The United States are still holding this area, Mataram, and holding the areas here. The British are holding Port Moresby, and the United States are holding Hollandia, probably the area held by the Netherlands before the Japanese took it. Okay, Australia is still held by the British. So we can say that the Japanese did well and killed off the Chinese. They won the war in China. They went on and took areas from the United States on these ISILs. They crushed Thailand, and they have also crushed the British in East Asia. The British are no more. So only Japan and the Soviet Union remains. However, India still has a few areas down here. So Japan has even sent an army here and is about to attack the British in Colombo. I don't know if the British held that area from the start. They might have done that. Or it was a Portuguese or Indian area, but I think it might have been British from the start. But the Japanese have shown that they can send troops with their ships and take ISILs. Then we have the Indians. They are still holding mainland India, but are currently in a war against the Japanese. And Japan has taken all the areas that belong to the British in India. So, and I believe that the Indian faction will lose against Japan, not only because Japan is a huge area, but because India doesn't have any planes in this mod. They are the best unit, so. Alright, Japan is winning the war in Asia. Only the Soviet Union remains as an obstacle for their domination there. They are the strongest faction in the game, but the Soviet Union is about the same strength, just slightly weaker according to the balance of power. Okay, so that's the world map. Let's remove the toggle FOV. And we have no peace yet. We have achieved peace with Portugal. We do not have peace with the others yet. Let's check our agents if we have more diplomats and such. Diplomat in Madrid, yes. He failed to make peace with the Spanish. We have one outside of Tirana too, he failed as well. Then we have one outside of the United States. We will try to make peace with the United States.
Left click on the listed offer and demand.
Alright, we will ask for peace. Ah, they agreed. United States agreed. I believe that the reason the United States agreed is because we have never fought them in battle. So they are not as mad at our faction as the others are. I mean, the Spanish state have lost at least one battle against us where we probably exterminated their troops, and Soviets have lost quite a few battles, so they are less willing to let us live or accept a peace, but or ceasefire. The United States accepted, so we are now at peace with the United States. The Third Reich and the United States have a peace. Alright. We do not. We need peace with the French Republic too. Alright, we're done. Next turn. The Soviet Union are besieging Berlin again. They are attacking. Their general Nikita Schott is attacking the city with 912 men. We are defending with Captain Jorg, 208 men. And now the entire force is inside of the city. So they have lots of infantry, some planes, and a general. Let's just automatically resolve. Clear victory. Alright, the statistics are not in our favor anymore. The enemy general, Captain Nikolai, have 435 men. Mostly planes, some infantry, one tank unit. And we lost quite a few in the previous auto-resolved battle. But we have at least one unit of jets still remaining. Okay, save the game. Right, so actually we could automatically resolve the battle. We will lose clear defeat because the battle is over. They took Berlin. Soviet Union have taken Berlin now. I believe we would have won more than once if we had fought it in real time, but I felt like the war is over anyway. No point wasting time fighting that battle in real time. Alright, so settlement besiege Berlin by Soviet Union. Settlement besiege again, same. And the settlement exterminated Berlin. This fine German settlement has been razed to the ground. The inhabitants have been slaughtered or sold into slavery. End of turn report. We have 3,413 profits. Construction completed. We have a howitzer training ground completed in Stettin. And the recruitment completed. We have a Messerschmitt 109 fighter in Stettin as well. Diplomatic information. We have a ceasefire with the United States. And there is also a ceasefire between the French Republic and the Italian Empire and the United States and the Italian Empire. Soviets are holding the German capital and the French are marching towards Frankfurt with an army. And another one is marching towards Amsterdam. We only have a unit of infantry. Alright guys, I believe we want, we do not want to give the Spanish state such a developed city. Let's just raise everything to the ground before they take the city. Destroy every building that we can destroy will be destroyed. Couldn't destroy the farms. We'll destroy everything else that we can destroy. The Spanish state won't get a lot of stuff when they take the city. Alright, you can't destroy anything more. They will get the large city building, the east wall defense, and the road, of course, the asphalt road, and the farms plus three. The city, large city of Amsterdam, capital of Belgium, will not be as valuable to the Spanish anymore when they take it. And the city of Hamburg. Could use a plane there actually.
Yaman Kaiser. Robert. Befehle Kaiser.
Alright, in this settlement we're constructing jet fighters one turn left. We lost Berlin, I forgot. Okay. So we have a diplomat over here.
Mein Kaiser.
Peace with the British would be good. Yeah, the British agreed to a peace deal. We have a ceasefire with the British. Now we will see if the Soviet Union, they didn't agree. All right, the Spanish down. You want peace with them as well. And we can give them an area even. Amsterdam. They didn't agree with it. They said no to peace, even though we offered them Amsterdam as well. Alright. They said no to peace, right. Alright, next time. So Erwin Rommel entered Copenhagen, the capital of Denmark. Soviet Union is attacking Frankfurt, so they attacked before the Spanish could do it. Army under Captain Luca is invading. They have a unit of ML-20 artillery and a lot of planes and tanks. They have 8 planes versus our 7. We have a jet fighter too. We could win this battle. Okay. We could win. I will just auto-resolve it. Clear victory. Spanish state, they might attack as well. Right, I'm back. The game crashed on the Spanish state's turn, but in this version of the mod I believe it could continue. I loaded an autosave, and I believe if you click next turn now it won't crash on the same spot. I might be wrong, but we will see. So Irwin entered Copenhagen again. Soviet Union didn't attack this time. They attacked Frankfurt last time. They didn't now. No one attacked. Instead, the Soviet Union marched their army towards Hamburg. And they're about to attack Hamburg instead. We do not want them to have any of our good stuff in Hamburg. We will destroy every building there. Academy. Everything else that we can destroy. Small park. Civil headquarters. Small tank factory. Leave nothing to the Soviets. Medium concern. Mortar training ground. Trader. Right. So they only get the buildings that are there from the start. We can't destroy. Alright. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. So Britain declared war on the German Reich again. French state have declared war on the Italian Empire. Alright, so Britain declared war, probably because of their fleet. They are probably blockading a port or something. But we destroyed the port now, so it shouldn't be a problem. So just destroy the ports. There's a Spanish state here. That battle. They have the same type of trip. They have troopers because it's a smaller faction in the game. I mean, Spain is a great power, but they were not in the war and they were weakened by their civil war, so they do not have a lot of good stuff. They do not have better ships than the troopers, but we only have troopers in these fleets anyway. But to resolve, we won the battles at the sea. And destroyed the Spanish fleet. I was surprised that Britain didn't send their fleet here instead. We have other ships here, including the Bismarcks and the Prince Eugen ships, and even some Hermelins. Let's move them to the troopers. Merge the ships. We have the British fleet down here. We will face them. And we have a new unit of MB262s in Frankfurt. Of course, that means we will construct a new one and build a big concern. Actually, we could use the SPG training ground instead. Try to get the peace deal with the British again. Ceasefire, trade rights. Yeah, they agreed. Good. So we have peace with Britain again. And we'll return the fleet to this port. We can't. Alright, actually, in Copenhagen we can destroy the port as well. So no one will locate it. Port in Sweden isn't ours, it's rebel. And this port in Berlin is now held by the Soviet Union. I believe this port isn't in danger of being attacked by the British. But the ships are. Alright. So, Soviet attacked Stettin. We have Gunther Alterbung and his army. Quite a huge army with lots of tigers, tiger ones and such. They have total air superiority. Let's against autoresolve, average defeat, they took Stettin as well. And Gundralterbung fell in battle. Now they are attacking Hamburg as is expected. Here we had another general. We had Reinhold Oschmann there with one unit of Hofstra's cardboard guard and a Messerschmitt 109 fighter. We will auto-resolve. We actually managed to win that, surprisingly enough. Vienna revolted to the German Reich and Soviets are attacking the revolting infantry. We will auto-resolve, clear defeat, and the Soviets retook Vienna and crushed the revolting Germans there. And another turn. Now the Soviet armies are outside of Frankfurt. Settlement besieged, Stettin. Settlement exterminated, Stettin. Settlement besieged, Hamburg. Settlement besieged, Vienna. Settlement occupied, Vienna. End of turn report. So we are 2054 in profits. We have 2054 profits. Diplomatic information, we have a war with Britain again, what the fuck? Seems to be enforced, alright. So we are still holding Amsterdam, Hamburg, and Copenhagen. Alright. And the only city of importance, Frankfurt. Next turn. So the Soviet Union finally attacked our last stronghold, the large city of Frankfurt, a German city, held by George Becker, a general. He has 389 men, including 7 Messerschmitt 109 fighters, 1 officer's bodyguard, armored officer's car bodyguard, and 2 riflemen, 2 assault infantry, and 1 Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane. The enemy under Piotr Vigilo has a lot of planes and infantry and bodyguard of armored officer's car. An armored officer's car bodyguard. So we could automatically resolve that. Clear victory. They attacked immediately again. Even more planes. Resolve. Clear victory again. Heroic victory here. Alright. Frankfurt was saved thanks to the jet fighters mostly. British fleet is upon us. Let's attack with our fleet. Their fleet consists of a lot of black swans. And troopers. Alright. So they have the ordinary troop ship that everyone has, and then they have the Black Swan, which is their corvette or whatever. I believe it's a corvette. We will auto-resolve this. We could win. We have also a lot of troopers. Then we have the Hermelin, our version of the Black Swan, and then we have the Bismarcks and the Prince Eugen. That's why we will win. So we have better ships. Let's auto-resolve, clear victory. So we defeated the British fleet there. Let's move down and face the Spanish now. They have nothing against our Bismarcks, etc. Let's merge their ships. We lost a few in the battle. Settlement besieged Frankfurt. Settlement besieged Frankfurt again for a second time. End of turn report, we have 3,354 in profits. Agent found of the Spanish state. Alright. An enemy agent has been found, but he escaped. Alright. Marriage celebrations. Reinhold Ochmann and Ingrid has married. Diplomatic information. Nothing interesting. So here is the Spanish state spy. Same as us, but with the black dress instead of red. We are still constructing the Messerschmitt 262 fighter jet there and building the SPG training ground. So Union are about to attack again with even more planes. Alright, next turn. I've given up on sending diplomats to them. They will have to send diplomats to us. Alright, so we have the Soviet Union with an entire army here attacking Frankfurt. I will just auto-resolve. Clear defeat! George Becker was killed in battle. His army of 304 men, including 7 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighters, 1 unit of Messerschmitt 262 fighter jets, 1 armored officer's car, 2 assault infantry units, and 3 assault infantry units, and 1 rifleman were defeated by the Soviet army. Alright, and the details of the battle. Alright. And that's it. A clear defeat. Frankfurt was taken by the Soviet Union. We burnt the city. Probably exterminated. A candidate for Dopion got another general inside of Hamburg. Send one of the generals down to Amsterdam to hold the city against the Spanish state. They have a unit of Panzer I's and Diego Bermejo, family member. Probably with an armored officer's car. Diplomatic information, Portugal and the French Republic have a ceasefire. Faction announcement, the hero's death, George Becker died. A new faction heir, Reinhold Ochmann. End of turn report, we have 1,950 in profits. Settlement exterminated Frankfurt, alright. So there. Next turn. Soviet Union attacked again. They attacked Amsterdam. So they were first to attack Amsterdam and not the Spanish state. They attacked with 1 unit of T-4-85 tanks, 1 unit of MiG-3 fighter jets, 2 actually, and 1 unit of SLT infantry. We only had a general, an armored officer's car general, and the rifleman, the SLT infantry there. Let's auto-resolve, clear defeat. Soviet took Amsterdam, the capital of Belgium, before the Spanish could do it. They've taken most of the Reich. Rioting in Amsterdam, yeah, but it was taken by the Soviet Union, so... So the map isn't looking good. Let's actually enable toggle FOV. What's happening in the Far East? So nothing has changed from the ISILs there. However, the Japanese Empire have taken most of the Indian areas, as I suspected they would. They failed to take Colombo from the British, but they have taken Bangalore from the from India. They've taken Hyderabad and Bombay. India still has their capital here, their current capital. I have no idea if it's their real capital, but Vasco da Gama is their current capital and they are still holding it. They have 2 units inside and 3 units outside, and they have a unit outside of Bombay. General faction air, Vindpun. With an armored officer's car, bodyguard. Okay, so Japan is clearly winning the war against India. So half of Asia is under their control. However, Soviet is still strong in these areas. There are some revolting areas there too. Can zoom in on the map, we see the grey areas, they are revolting areas. So Asia is now a battlefield between Soviet and Japan. What about the Americans? They have withdrawn their troops from South America and are no longer planning to betray the League of Nations. Okay. Rioting Amsterdam. Settlement besieged Amsterdam as well. Exterminator as well. End of turn report, we have 548 profits. Heroic death, Felix Rommel, family member died. the Battle of Amsterdam, probably. Diplomatic information. Following factions are now at war with each other. French Republic and Portugal are at war. Alright. And that's for the rest of the map. What is happening? Soviet Union. They're about to enter the Middle East here. Three units. Britain still holds Turkey, Istanbul and Saloniki. But the Soviet Union have now taken Tirana from the Italian Empire. They're now controlling all the areas that the Italian Empire had taken in Greece and Albania. They've also retaken Verona from the Italian Empire and taken Milano as well. Now we're bordering the Spanish state. The Spanish state had a rich areas to save all of Spain, with the exception of the two areas held by Portugal. They are about to attack Portugal, I think. They have an entire army here. Alright, we only have Hamburg, German city, held by Reinhold Oschmann, faction air and a unit of planes, and then we have Copenhagen and Oslo. Alright, next turn. Soviet Union have really become huge on the map. An unstoppable juggernaut. Okay. Italy only has two areas. Rome itself and Bali over here. So they are almost defeated. I'm sure the Soviet Union is going to attack Hamburg soon. Diplomatic information. The Italian Empire has a ceasefire with the French Republic, Spanish State and the United Soviet. United States of America. End of turn report. We have 1156 in profits, or 1156. Okay, next turn. Candidate for adoption. End of turn report. We have 1220 in profits, or 1220. New family member, Emilia. Diplomatic information. Okay. Seems the Spanish state took Raven from Portugal. Now only Bordeaux is held by Portugal here. And surrounded by the Spanish army. Or armies. But the Soviet Union are prepared to invade the fascist Spain. Nation soon, I believe. I would be surprised if they didn't attack the Spanish. They also want to destroy the Italians. Alright, next turn. Amsterdam. Revolt to the Germans. We got a lot of planes there. They still have the upper hand. That's autoresolving. Clear victory, actually. They won the Battle of Amsterdam, but they sent another army to Amsterdam immediately after our victory. Another army with even more troops. Autoresolving, we had a clear defeat and Amsterdam was lost once again. And now the Soviet Union are attacking Hamburg for the first time. With three plane units, actually. We have two generals there. Hermann Grimm and Reinhold Oschmann, the faction air. And we lost, both of them died, and we lost the plane unit as well. Hamburg has fallen. Alright, and the Spanish state are now besieging Bordeaux, held by the Portuguese. diplomatic information, nothing interesting. Amsterdam was besieged maybe two times and then occupied by the Soviet Union. Hamburg was besieged and occupied by the Soviet Union. We have 185 in profits now, way less than we used to. We have almost no cities left. We lost Reinhold Oschmann and Hermann Grimm. And Retinue expands Erwin Rommel, who is residing currently in Copenhagen, the capital of Denmark. We have an army of Spain here too. Okay, in Upper Denmark. Let's move the fleet towards the Spanish fleet here. They have three troopers against all of this. We'll kill them off. We'll sink all of them. Sink this fleet as well. Sink this one too. Our fleet is reigning supreme in these waters. We have peace with Portugal, we do not need to attack them. We can't move the fleet anymore this time. So I guess we could reach this area by land. I didn't know that was possible. It is possible. So Erwin Rommel could indeed move towards Oslo, the capital of Norway, because Copenhagen is next to be attacked. About other areas of the world. What about Turkey? Nothing is happening here. No war between the British and the Soviet Union. Okay, what about the Japanese? The Soviet Union have retaken the areas here that had revolted. A few areas down here are still. One area actually. The British army outside. Captain Joffre has quite a huge army, but Peshawar has revolted from the British then. Okay, and the Japanese have defeated the armies here, but India is not entirely crushed yet. We have one area left with all the forces guarding it that they had split up around the city previously. El Ayun, held by the Spanish state, was taken by the United States of America, and the Spanish state are also blockading the port at Marrakesh. The United States are fighting the Spanish state in Africa. They just removed them from Africa. Bordeaux is still besieged by the Spanish state. Soviet army is moving towards Copenhagen, as I suspected they would do. Let's move all most of the troops to Oslo. Portuguese army in this area. In Norway. Diplomatic information. The following facts are now at war with each other. The British Commonwealth of Nations, the League of Nations, the French Republic and the United States of America have declared war on the Spanish state. They are all countries, the Roman factions. The League of Nations is the Senate, and the other three are the actual Romans, the Bruti, the July, and whatever the third one was named. Alright, and they have declared war on the Spanish state, because the Spanish state has become pretty strong. They are holding most of France, after all, and the Netherlands, and Spain itself. Alright, what about the fleet? Could move them towards the Spanish ships over there, and next turn. Soviet Union is attacking Copenhagen. We only had a riflemen unit there, we have lost the city already, they took it. Now we only have Oslo, the capital of Norway. I expect the Soviet armies to enter Sweden. reach us. Move the riflemen to Oslo, where we have two rifleman units now and one assault infantry unit and the air himself, Erwin Rommel. Settlement besieged Copenhagen. Yes. Settlement occupied Copenhagen as well. Faction destroyed. Portugal has been destroyed. Their army has disappeared. Their fleet has disappeared. They were killed off in Bordax. The Spanish state took their area there. And their leader died probably. That's why they revolted in their capital. Where they still have an army now. A rebel army. End of turn report. We are -174 in profits. We only have Oslo now. And nothing new in the diplomatic window. Nothing new has happened. So the Soviet Union took the capital of Denmark and are moving into Italy now, the Italian Empire. Haven't declared war on the Spanish state yet. What about the Japanese? Has anything happened? They are surrounding the area of Vasco da Gama, held by India. It's the capital currently of India. India has revolted in Bangalore, a large city. I also have a fleet of trooper ships. And in Turkey nothing has happened. Soviets are not moving down. Alright. Next turn. Become protectorate. The Soviet Union has finally asked Germany to become a protectorate. They will accept. And yeah. They still attacked. We said yes to becoming their protectorate and they still attacked because Hamburg revolted. They wanted Hamburg. That's the problem with this mod, that the Soviet Union have a constant revolt. There are some areas that could use some loyalty to certain factions. We have two generals in Oslo now. We got a new general. Paul Dissel, family member. And in the besieged Hamburg area, we have planes and a rifleman unit. Betrayed, the Soviet Union attacked because we revolted. Hamburg is under siege, we have -107 in profits. Diplomatic information. We became a client kingdom, then they attacked us. Because we revolted. Marriage celebrations. Paul Dissel and Mila has been married. Okay. So the Spanish state has an army in the area of territory of Berlin. Huge army. Alright. The Soviet Union have taken Rome, the capital of the Italian Empire. They only have Bali left now. I think they are unstoppable. Italy, and in this front they still haven't attacked the British. There are some revolts here too. So the Indians, the area of Bangalore has been retaken by the Japanese, but they are still holding the capital. Alright, next turn. Soviet Union are attacking again. They're attacking Hamburg, I'm pretty sure of that. Fight the force. We might win. It's very equal. Autoresolve. Clear victory, good. They will attack again, of course. And we will lose this one. Der Feind wartet vor den Mauern. Er belagert uns. And clear defeat. Hamburg was occupied once again by the Soviet Union. Our fleet is still attack them. Attack the Spanish fleet. Could easily win against it. Because we have huge ships and they only have troopers. Okay. Settlement besieged, Hamburg. Settlement occupied, Hamburg. The turn report by minus 235 in profits. Alright. What about the Japanese? I want to know what's happening over there. Okay, next turn. So Union have attacked us somewhere. Copenhagen revolted to the Germans and Soviets are attacking once again, but we only have infantry revolting, so we will lose that. Clear defeat. Alright. Suitable husband. Betrothed. Sabin. Not sure how to say that. Oh! The Japanese has taken Vasco da Gama from India. That means the faction is destroyed. Settlement besieged Copenhagen by the Soviet Union. Settlement occupied Copenhagen. Faction destroyed. India was destroyed by the Japanese Empire. End of turn report were minus 887 in profits. Diplomatic information. Marriage celebrations. Ulrich Guderian has married Sabine. Alright, so Japan is victorious and only has the Soviet Union as an enemy. You can say Asia has been divided between the Japanese Empire and the Soviet Union. So now it's a war between Japan and the Soviet Union, but I believe they will be plagued by a lot of revolts. Also, the Japanese seem to have destroyed the British army as well. That was outside of Peshawar. Yeah, so the British are also removed from Asia. What about the ISIL that they held? Yeah, they are still holding the ISIL here with the city of Colombo. Okay. And Spanish state has of course taken Lisbon from Portugal. Capital of Portugal, but it was held by the rebels because Portugal was destroyed, so they took it from the rebels. They're now holding all of this. They believe the Spanish state are too weak to fight the Soviet Union. Not only do they have less territory, but they also have weaker troops. They will be crushed in the end. As for the Italians, they still hold the Bali. Next turn, or end turn in this game. Ah, a revolt in Hamburg again. So we have four generals in Oslo now. Actually, I want to speak with the Soviet Union.
Mein Kaiser, ich werde das Reich vertreten, Kaiser.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create
map
proposal.
Information.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty.
You think they would never take the city otherwise, so we will do this. That's Hamburg, that's not good. We need to change capital. Hamburg, the German city, will be the capital.
At this time it would be...
This faction to be the faction's capital, good. By the way, I forgot one thing. We could actually check the cities in battle. forgot to do that. But it's possible to see the cities when the troops move around the city in peacetime. Okay, now let's speak to the... Actually, we'll speak to the British.
Left click on the listed offer and demand
item. How? Give region.
An item in the proposal to
who's slow? If we give us a little British.
Treaty proposal.
Map
is
information. Map information. Ceasefire trade rights. I don't think the peace will last long, but anyway, we'll try. So Britain would have been likely to take Oslo. So we let them have it. They got them a garrison there. Okay, then we'll move this troop unit, the generals and the troops there. Now they need to leave British territory. Alright, next time. Hamburg is under siege. The general Vladimir Shuko is invading. He has a huge force. Right. The result clear defeat. Hamburg was lost despite all the planes. We had a lot of revolting units, including Stuka, tactical bombers, and other stuff. We lost because we lost the last territory. Anyway, we were defeated. We wouldn't have won with Rommel and his few troops anyway. Victory conditions failed. Your faction has been wiped out. Others will write the histories and claim your accomplishments as their own. Your faction has been wiped out. Others will write the histories and claim your accomplishments as their own. Better luck next time. Return to the main menu is the only option now. Okay, I think maybe the UX could add a defeat video, so when Germany loses or something, we would have like a video of Germany in ruins or something. Anyway, the campaign is over. Thanks for watching. Now I will mod the game and add Dagovax's stats to all the units, the stats from the 2.0 version. I will also attempt to add the units from that version to this mod, because I know how to move units from one mod to another in Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms, and in Rome Total War it's similar, but the files are slightly different, so I will still need to maybe get used to doing it in Rome Total War, but because I have done it many times in Medieval 2, I believe it shouldn't be much of a problem to do it in Rome Total War either. So I will move over the new tanks, new artillery, etc, etc, and add his new stats, which will nerf the planes and make other units more balanced, the infantry and the tanks, etc. And then I will... I already have added the new brick wall. It's just we never fought in a battle with that wall, but it's in this version actually. So we will have the new brick wall the next time, and we will have the new stats and new units, and I also believe that I will change some starting armies before I start the let's play. For example, I want the Soviet armies to not only consist of T-34 tanks. Instead, I'd make them more interesting, and as for other things, I believe maybe the Finnish army should get a boost in strength. They should have the same numbers, but they should have a higher level. Their unit should be higher level, so that their units could... one army of Finnish soldiers should be able to defeat three or four armies of Soviets. Otherwise, they will be too easily defeated, like in this campaign. In this game, you know, the units can level up to level 9. So if you give them a higher level than the Soviet troops, they will be able to win with one army against many Soviet armies, which will be more historically accurate. And as for the custom cities, I will ask Dagovax what the procedure is to, you know, move over Berlin. or move over the French cities, the Italian cities, because the other version has all of these cities already in this campaign. But unfortunately, the campaign is so unstable that it crashes. CTDs crash to desktop on turn 2 or turn 3 or turn 4. So you can't really play it, and because of this issue, I prefer to move over everything to this version that is actually stable. Of course, this version can crash every once in a while, even on the map, but every time you start it up, you can continue. In that version, it would crash every time at the same spot, so you can't continue when it crashes. As soon as the CTD has happened, on, let's say if the mod CTD is on turn 2, then when you start it up and play it again, it will CTD on turn 2 again. Well, in this version, you will be able to continue. Okay, so the mod did reach 1945, so the game was over in early 1945. We have no winter yet, so it's early 1945, and the war is lost for Germany, and the let's play is over. This was the final episode, but I will do the changes I mentioned, and I might also change a few things. Maybe remove some tanks from some factions to make it more like Dagovax wanted, and I mean he wanted some factions to not have tanks. I will probably remove those tanks and then make things more like in the official version, because I did some personal changes here to be more close to history, but now I want to play it like he intended. But yeah, I would like to have those custom cities, but I don't know how to move them over. I will ask Dagovax, maybe I will send the mod in, maybe he can help me, but I don't know. In the worst case, we won't have them in the next Let's Play either. But I will have new units and new balance and other stuff, so it will still be different, but in the worst case, we won't have Berlin or the French cities or the Italian cities. Okay, thanks for watching, and this was the 18th episode. I started this Let's Play back in January, and it ended on December 23rd, 2020. Okay, so this is the first finished Let's Play in a Total War that I played, and yeah, it ended in defeat. Victory conditions failed, so it was a disaster. It went about the same as in real life when it comes to Germany, at least. By the way, the Soviet Union is about to invade the Spanish state, but they never did move against them. And Italians are still holding Bali at the time of the defeat. It's about United States. The United States have conquered Mexico from the League of Nations, taken the areas here, and now are about to enter South America. They are at war with the League of Nations. Okay. Then Japan. They crushed India, as we saw. Now they've retaken areas from the rebels again, but they revolt all the time. Alright. So Asia is a divided territory between the Japanese Empire and the Soviet Union. War between the League of Nations and the United States is about to reach South America. From earlier previews of this mod, I believe the United States have the superior army, so they will win that war. And then here, I'm pretty sure that the Soviet Union would destroy the Spanish state and destroy Italy in a few turns. However, Britain is stronger, they might be able to hold them back if a war were to break out there. Alright, and Africa is held by the Roman factions, the United States, the British Empire, and the French Republic, so I believe peace would last very long in Africa. Okay, thanks for watching, and see you on the next campaign. 1944